The food industry is a complex network of activities that deals with the supply, consumption, and catering of food products and services across the world. Every day, we can choose from a broad variety of fresh, safe, wholesome, and good-tasting foods to make our meals. The inherent safety, convenience, availability, nutritional content, aesthetic appeal, and variety that typify our food supplies are a hallmark of modern life. But this was not always the case. For much of this bounty, we can credit the contributions and efforts of chemical engineers.
For more than 100 years, chemical engineers have used their unique expertise to conceive, design, test, and scale up revolutionary food processing techniques.
Through their efforts, we now expect exotic fruits and vegetables, fresh meats, seafood, and dairy products to always be available in our local grocery shelves. Some of the innovations and milestones made by chemical engineers in the food industry are fertilizers, convenience foods, novel packaging methods, and strides to improve food safety. The roles of chemical engineers in the food industry encompasses diverse sectors such as agriculture, food processing, regulation and distribution, and research and development.
The food industry is so important, mainly because food is essential to life. The hierarchy of needs puts forth food as one of our most basic needs. And without it, the pyramid would topple over. This is why the chemical engineering community continues to work on even more advanced techniques to bring sustainable food systems.
In the Philippines, creating a sustainable food system is definitely not a walk in the park. This is why I believe that the food and agriculture industry should be prioritized and given more focus. Achieving food sustainability is definitely a must. However, we are clearly far from reaching that goal.
The Philippines is an archipelagic country where agriculture plays a vital role in providing around 30% of employment and 10% of the country's total gross domestic product in 2013. Currently, we are faced with the challenges of meeting the food demands for our increasing population.
Insufficient food supply could lead to more malnutrition, higher poverty levels, and heightened social unrest. Food prices today are at an all-time high, and it is getting harder and harder for people, especially those living in poverty, to avail food. Population growth also affects the amount of arable land in the Philippines. Increasing population also increases the demand for housing, which leads to smaller farms and decrease in food production.
Climate change also threatens our food security. Drought in some places and increasing rainfall in others will cause crop losses and lower livestock and food production. Since the Philippines is an archipelago, it makes us sensitive to these changes. Thus, we face the challenge of ensuring there is enough food for all. Furthermore, our lack of innovation and investments on food industry makes it more difficult for us to achieve food sustainability.
An example is the ban of the genetically modified BT talong, an insect-resistant variety of eggplant, which threatens other genetically modified crops that contribute to food security. The lack of support for our science and technology researchers is becoming a hindrance for our development.
And finally, the recent Kinapawan incident. The Philippines is an agricultural country, yet our farmers are hungry. Our farmers are facing extreme drought and starvation, but instead of getting help, they are being killed because they ask for food to eat. Just imagine, we are in a country where our farmers have no food to eat. Why does tragedy have to happen before we awaken our conscience and awareness in this country? Something has to be done, and change is what we need.
We have to boost our food and agricultural industry. One way to do this is to encourage investors to fund in this endeavor. Since the Philippines is an agricultural country, investing in food and agriculture will guarantee fruitful outcomes. We can adopt the technologies used in other countries. We should keep the welfare of our farmers in check, for they are the food producers of our country.
Another approach we can take is to incentivize research and development in this field. Investments and public support are key factors in order to make sure this happens. By doing this, researchers in our country will not be demotivated to go into research and development because they would be given grants and scholarships that will help them in their research. This will also lead to the development of GMOs, which is one of the most promising and safest strategies to increase global total food production, reduce crop losses, and increase nutritional content.
Well, it is evident that our country faces the problem of food insecurity.
The problems we face are global, but their impact is personal.
The food industry is an important industry that needs a technological step up to meet local and global demands.
The Philippines is an agricultural country, and we must utilize that in order to catapult us into becoming a more developed country.
Giving priority to the food industry will not only provide our country economic growth and sustainable food, but it will also establish a joyous and harmonious community.
At the end of the day, we only have ourselves to rely on to be the change we want to see in the world.